Hello everyone, our today's topic is capacity. We will be learning about what is capacity, how is capacity measured, how to convert measuring units of capacity, the maximum amount of space that a vessel has to hold or contain liquid inside it is called its capacity. There are different vessels around us, such as bottle, a glass, and a jug are used to hold water and milk. A bowl is used for containing soup, a cup is for holding tea or coffee. Drums and other similar containers hold and carry oils. Gas cylinders hold liquid gas as fuel, etc. Look, here we have a bottle full of water and an empty glass. Let's pour water from the bottle in the glass. Did you notice? The water started spilling from the glass, yet there is still more water in the bottle. So this bottle can contain more water as compared to this glass. This shows that different containers have different capacities or space to hold liquids. Different types of vessels or containers have different capacities to hold liquids. For example, look at this glass, bottle, and can. Do you think they can contain same amount of water? No, because they are of different sizes, and the bigger the size, the bigger the capacity. Looking at these three containers, we find that the glass can contain no more than 250 milliliters of water. The bottle can hold a maximum of 1 liter of water, and the can's maximum capacity is 5 liters. So, as the size grew, the capacity grew too. These are three bowls of different sizes. Which one do you think can contain the most amount of soup? Yes, the one in the middle is the largest in size, so it has the highest capacity among all three. Now, which one can hold least amount of soup? Yes, the one on the right, because it is the smallest in size. Sometimes containers appear larger or smaller than others, but in reality they are not, because they have the same amount of space for holding water and other liquids. For example, have a look at these five different bottles. They have different shapes and colors and slightly different heights and widths, but they all have the same amount of space or capacity, that is 1 liter. Units of capacity. Now that you know what capacity means, let's find out what the measuring units of capacity are. The capacity for all liquid is measured in liter, that is denoted by L, and milliliter, that is denoted by ml. Remember, 1L is equal to 1000 milliliter. Liter is the bigger measuring unit, and milliliter is the smaller measuring unit. So, in large containers, we measure capacity in liters, and if the container is small, we use milliliters. For instance, this small vial has the capacity to hold 25 milliliters of water or any liquid. This cup has the capacity to contain 200 milliliters of liquid. And this jug has the capacity to hold 2 liters of liquid. Conversion of measuring units. Converting liters into milliliters. If we want to convert liters into milliliters, we have to multiply the liters with 1000, as 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. For instance, let's convert 5 liters into milliliters. 5 liter is equal to how many milliliters? 5 multiplied by 1000 is equal to 5000. Therefore, we know 5 liters are equal to 5000 milliliter. Now, how many milliliter do you think there are in 58 liters? Let's find out the same way we did before. 58 liter is equal to how many milliliters? 58 multiplied by 1000 is equal to 58,000. Therefore, there are 58,000 milliliters in 58 liters. Converting milliliters into liters. We can also convert milliliters into liters. If we want to convert liters into milliliters, we have to divide the milliliters by 1000, as 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. For instance, let's convert 25,000 milliliters into liters. 25,000 is equal to how many liters? 25,000 divided by 1000 is equal to 25. Thus, there are 25 liters in 25,000 milliliters. So, remember, when you want to convert liters, larger measuring unit, into milliliters, smaller measuring unit, you have to multiply the number with 1000. And when you want to convert milliliters, smaller measuring unit, into liters, larger measuring unit, you have to divide the number by 1000. We hope now you have learned about capacity. If some concepts are not clear, then replay the video again and again. Still, if you have some questions, then ask your teacher.